Christians cries out, Fulani militants are killing us in Kaduna. Attacks by Fulani militants against Christian community in Kaduna State continued leading up to Christmas. At least 18 people were killed and many others abducted in the village of Ongwan Waziri, Gwanzunu Baja Katama, Galumi, Kugasi, Gora, and Kujeni Tudu. These attacks all took place within a week of Christmas, with the abduction of a reverend wife on Christmas Eve. On December 17th, 10 people were killed by Fulani militants in Goraga village of Zangon Kataf local government area. That same day, other militants also attacked the village of Kujeni Tudu, killing one older man. On December 19, Reverend Luca Dani of the Evangelical Church Winning All in Galumi village was abducted. He was later released on December 23rd. It is unclear if any ransom was paid or why he was taken at this time. He has been forced to flee his home and church, though. On December 21st, Reverend Thomas James of Godia Baptist Church, Gwazunu, was taken as well. During these attacks, the militants also destroyed the nearby village of Bajakatama, where they killed 8 people. Finally, on December 24th, militants beat Reverend Luca Shahu of the Assemblies of God Church in Ongwan Waziri. They then proceeded to abduct the pastor's wife, Mrs. Chumai Luca. She is still missing at this time. All of these attacks and abductions of pastors show that Fulani militants hold a clear hatred for the church, though it is unclear what they intend by these attacks, or if there is any coordination between different militant groups. It is clear that the church in Nigeria is under attack. Please continue to pray for the safety and security of our brothers and sisters in Nigeria. Thank you for listening to this news. My dear, before I will even think of start praying for any Christians in Kaduna State, the Christians should just leave that place first. They should just leave that place. The Christians should just quietly leave that place, or else I will not say a single prayer for anybody. Yes, I will not say a single prayer for them. How many times have they been told to leave Kaduna? How many times? Can you imagine? They are killing you people and you people are still there. Why wouldn't they kill you? With all this that is happening in Kaduna, with all this that we are hearing that is happening, the bandits visiting, invading Kaduna, killing and abducting people, and you people still foolishly remain there, saying that you have an asset in Kaduna, that you have buildings in Kaduna. Those buildings and assets, are they better than your life? Are they better than your life? Yeah, you stay there now and kill yourself then. You are crying out that they are killing you people. You are crying out that they are killing Christians. What else do you expect? What do you want people to do? What do you want Christians in Lagos, in the Southeast to do for you now? What do you want them to do for you? You want them to carry soldiers, behind them, and then walk down to Kaduna and start fighting the Northerners. People must not be serious. You must not be serious. If you know what is good for you and you love your life, you better leave that place. You better leave that place before they wipe the whole of you away in Kaduna. I don't know what people are still doing there. Eh? You despite all this that is happening, you are still there. You're still there. Who is instigating you? Who is advising you? Who is advising you? I'm afraid. I can remember vividly that you people were advised to leave the north. You people were advised to leave the north the last time you were attacked. Yet you refused to leave. You started giving all sorts of excuses concerning your property and all of that. Is that what we want to hear? Is that what we want to see? Yeah? Kaduna is not safe. It's not safe. You all supposed to live there. You're supposed to live there. Supposed to live there. I don't know who is advising you to still remain in Kaduna. Day after day, we keep getting information concerning missing lives, missing people, abducted people, and all of that. Yet, you people have refused to learn your lesson. You refuse to learn your lesson. The governor is there doing nothing. Doing nothing. When you approach him, he will tell you that his state is safe. That nothing is happening. You can imagine. You won't blame me now, because when he has been giving security guiding and following him up and down. So far his family is safe. Who is talking? Who is that talking? That is it now. Yeah? That is it. So you people invited what is happening to you. You are the cause of what is going on with you. So whether you will shed tears for money tonight, it is your problem. Carry it. You cost it. Carry it. You have been told to leave there. You refuse to leave. Stay there. Stay there. My viewers, the Christians are dying. Yes, we know, but they are the cause. They are the cause, because they have been advised to leave the north. They have been advised to stay away from the north, because the north is not their home. All right, so my dear viewers, please, your own idea and comments concerning this are very, very important. Extremely important. Deem it fit to leave those comments of yours below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.